Oh Lord, there's got to be a better way.
Captain Kirk, I do not make this request lightly.
Say it again.
It is urgent that you alter course for Gateway immediately.
There's got to be a better way.
Yeah. All hands manning battle stations. This is not a drill.
It's not our weapon.
The Doomsday War.
What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
Say it again.
Red alert.
Oh, damn.
What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
Say it.
War.
Good God.
What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
How do we know your correct history is the right one?
There's got to be a better way.
The best one.
Because, Jim.
Say it again.
Billions of people are dead.
There's got to be a
better
way.
All this for a history we don't know? For people we may or may not become?
Yeah.
Call it off while you still can.
What is it good for?
Devastating war that never should have happened. And now their future lies in the past. Two mighty starships, two courageous captains, one inescapable destiny to prevent Doomsday.
Now the cell. Shield energy is fluctuating. Circuits overloaded.
Helm is not responding, sir.
I suggest you target these coordinates.
All power to the app shield.
This prize is ours.
Dr. McCoy to the bridge. Medical emergency.
Oh my.
All hands, this is the captain. Prepare for saucer separation. I repeat, stand by to...
Such journeys are possible.
Project Timepiece can handle the situation.
I knew this would work.
Captain, as I'm sure Lieutenant Uhura has told you, my request has priority one authorization. You may confirm this with Starfleet Command, but you must comply. Spock out.
Well, priority one it is. Lieutenant Uhura, sound red alert. Helm, set course for Gateway.
Aye, sir. Coming to course 011, mark 30.
Commander, do you foresee any difficulty in navigating the time ripples in the Gateway system?
Mr. DeSalle should have no difficulty, Captain.
Very good, Commander Carr. Helm, you heard our first officer. Maximum warp.
Aye, sir.
McGregor, thank you. This is my chief medical officer, Dr. Leonard McCoy, my first officer, Commander Carr.
How do you do? This is Commander Spock.
Commander, there are no Vulcans in Starfleet.
There aren't any Vulcans anywhere.
Captain, as you know, Project Timepiece was established as a permanent research facility shortly after your discovery of the artifact on this planet.
Of course, Doctor, your reputation does precede you.
Then I hope you will take us seriously when we tell you that the natural course of time has been altered.
These figures represent the flow of time?
The natural flow of time, yes. Here are the readings I took only a few hours ago.
This is at least the magnitude 10 variation.
10.2. From that point on, history is no longer correct.
And if that's not enough, the same anti-proton signature shows up again, only a few months ago.
Corresponding to our battle with the planet-devouring weapon, commonly known as the Doomsday Machine.
Our battle?
Captain, until this shift in time, Mr. Spock was your first officer. Aboard the Enterprise.
Enterprise?
There's no ship name.
According to my research, you and the crew of the Farragut were assigned many of the same missions, had many of the same experiences, shared many of the same crises as the crew of the Enterprise.
Parallel timeline development is not without precedent.
Does that include letting Matt Decker die senselessly in a shuttlecraft?
Yes, including even that.
That and your discovery of this planet and the Vortex. Captain, you loan Commander Spock to us as a research consultant. He was protected from the changes in the timeline, as are we all here on Gateway.
Commander Spock, the Farragut has done battle with several of these killers since this Doomsday War began.
When Matt Decker was killed flying a shuttlecraft into the Doomsday weapon, when you detonated the Constellation inside that same device, Dr. McGregor's instruments registered a smaller, yet otherwise identical anti-proton surge.
So what you're really saying is you expect us to go back in time and change history so things go your way. Well, this is our life, our history.
How do we know your correct history is the right one, the best one?
Because, Jim, here, in your timeline, billions of people are dead. As you pointed out, Doctor, Vulcan and dozens of other worlds have been destroyed in the 14 years since the first of those machines appeared. In my timeline, those worlds are still there, vibrant, thriving, filled with life.
So that's what we're supposed to do? Use the Vortex, travel back in time to 2254, and stop these things before they can start a war?
Without the proper preparation, you would be annihilated along with everything else in your path. First, we must gather more information.
And exactly how do we do that? Sorry I asked.
It is our hope that by following this smaller, more recent pulse from your encounter with the Doomsday Weapon, we can get some sense of how these time deviations occur and how we might counter them.
The pulse leads to Earth in the 1960s, the most tumultuous time in your history. So much so, in fact, that I'm having difficulty getting an accurate reading.
Commander Spock, I have located the pulse. The energy signature proceeds through time until there. That must be the focal point.
The temporal foci should bring us within immediate proximity of whatever is causing the disturbance.
I concur.
Aspirin. Foci give me a headache.
The future's not going to save itself. Mr. Carter?
Stand by, Captain.
Our research indicates that you will automatically return when your mission is a success. Don't ask me how the Guardian knows.
5 years to go. 4.
This was easier with my veins full of cortisone.
3. 2. Now, Captain.
Commander, I thought you said we were heading for the 1960s. This looks more like the end of the century.
The beginning, actually. Readings indicate we have successfully traveled to 2006, where the anti-proton readings are the strongest.
Well done, Spock. Now what?
The signal emanates from that direction.
And what do you suggest we do? Knock?
Yes? May I help you?
Good afternoon, Miss...
Oh, my. It's you.
My name is Jim Kirk. We were hoping
of
that
you... Of course. Captain Kirk. Won't you come in, please? My name is Veronica. I'm so delighted that you finally made it.
Ma'am, Veronica, you were expecting us?
Well, I must admit I had my doubts. I've been waiting a long time. Please, sit down. He always said you'd show up, sooner or later. He made this tape for you.
Is it right, Ben? Yes, it works. It works. Just sit down and do it. Okay. Hello there.
Commodore Decker.
Yes. He made this 2 years ago. He died 8 months later.
Commodore Matthew Decker, this is my report. If you're watching this tape, it means someone from Starfleet has come looking for me. I'm betting it's Jim Kirk. But whoever it is, I'm sorry I missed seeing you. Now, first of all, please, don't worry. I did fine. Thanks to Veronica. You know that I commandeered a shuttlecraft from the Farragut. And after setting a course down the maw of that planet killer, I locked the autopilot in case I lost my nerve. 1 minute I was staring into the face of the devil incarnate. And the next, I'm flat on the floor of the shuttlecraft. Drifting in space, I must have blacked out. The thing was gone. The spaceships were gone. The radio was silent. All I could do was set a course for Earth. But when I got here, I discovered I was stuck in the past. I was in pretty bad shape. That was when Veronica found me and nursed me back to health, as it were. Helped me find my place, make a home here in the 20th century. Well, the 21st now, I guess. How many other men can say that they have seen three centuries? I suppose I should apologize to Admiral Leslie for not trying harder to get back where I started. But, well, you have met Veronica. And now it seems the years have finally caught up with me. So, this is my final report. Decker, out.
But this does not explain the tricorder readings.
Veronica, did Matt leave anything else?
You might say that, yes.
Does this explain your tricorder readings?
Yes, Captain. The shuttlecraft which disappeared along with Commodore Decker. If the microtapes are still intact.
Check it out, Spock.
Matt wanted me to give this to you.
Welcome back.
Since you're here, I assume...
Fascinating. Commodore Decker's sensor data would indicate that the weapon's conversion drive emits chronotons.
Chronotons? A quantum particle of time. Concentrations of chronotons can cause anomalous behavior in a local time flow.
Dr. McGregor, I noticed the Enterprise was mentioned several times throughout your logs.
Oh, yes, Captain. The Enterprise seems to have a knack for being at the center of things. Enterprise.
Fascinating.
Working.
The Enterprise was the first ship to encounter the planet killers.
Yes, Captain.
And it was destroyed almost immediately.
Also true, Doctor. In your timeline. Not in mine.
Then the Enterprise is the key. Was it not supposed to be there so that its crew would survive?
Or perhaps it is the planet killer, which was in the wrong place.
The wrong time, Mr. Karg.
Do you mean that thing came from the future?
Yes, Doctor. It arrived in your time, where there was no power great enough to stop it.
And it began burning worlds to fuel its anti-proton engine.
And to build duplicates until dozens prowled the galaxy.
The Doomsday War, which was never supposed to happen.
Mr. Karg, you said chronotons were unstable.
Yes, sir.
Could that be what happened then? When we detonated the Constellation, could we somehow have caused a dangerous chronoton burst?
And a smaller reaction from the shuttlecraft could have triggered the chronotons to send Commodore Decker back in time.
Commander Spock, could we somehow use that to our advantage? Cause a reaction that would send this thing back to its own time?
No, Captain. One starship would not be able to generate a reaction of sufficient magnitude.
Understood. And two?
Two ships would have a better chance.
Jim, what are you thinking? We don't have two ships.
Yes, we do, Bones. We have the Enterprise.
The Enterprise is in the past. Time travel, Captain?
We know exactly where and when the Enterprise will encounter the first Doomsday machine. If we could be there at the same time...
Captain, the slingshot effect is not precise.
We can emerge hours or weeks from our target.
That may not be necessary.
Shuttlecraft McAuliffe, you have been cleared for restricted airspace. Continue on this heading until instructed to land.
Affirmative. McAuliffe out.
This area wasn't so heavily shielded.
We would have used the transporter.
Where would be the fun in that?
Daniels discovered this about 8 months ago. A natural dam burst downstream and all this was exposed. The Federation pronounced it off-limits and suddenly we all had clearance level alpha.
No kidding.
I'm trying to figure out what it's for.
Colonization, perhaps. Or invasion.
Or research, or espionage, or purely voyeurism. The why has been our biggest question.
You have studied it, of course.
Not as much as we'd like. To tell you the truth, we're a little afraid of it.
That is wise.
Science analysis.
Well, fascinating, Captain.
Mr. Carr.
If you intend to use this to take the Farragut back in time.
My primary concern is whether or not it will operate.
Once it's cut loose and towed into space.
That's my thought, too. But you might have to use your tractor beam to control the...
No. No, you won't. Mr. DeSalle?
Well, sir, I think I could fly Farragut straight into this thing.
What? You mean down here?
You have the precise dimensions, right?
Well, of course.
There's got to be less than 100 feet clearance behind there. If we're wrong about the way this thing works...
Yeah, we'll wind up as cave paintings. I know.
Maybe a test using a shuttlecraft?
Kirk here.
Captain, long-range sensors have picked up a doomsday machine.
Heading in distance?
Sir, it's on a direct course for Planet Gateway.
Here?
They have been known to track the warp signatures of starships for several hundred light years.
It followed us.
Estimates put it in firing range in 2 hours.
Keep me posted, Lieutenant. Kirk out.
Well, that's that. We don't have time for a test. Mr. DeSalle, a starship is a creature of space. It's not meant to be flown in the atmosphere, and certainly not at the velocities that we're discussing here.
Yes, sir. But I think I can do this.
Kirk to Farragut.
Rand here, Captain.
Lieutenant, notify the hangar deck and prepare the crew for collision.
Sir?
You heard me, Rand.
Captain, I know Chris Pike. He will not be easy to convince.
Commander?
Open your mind, Jim. Our minds are merging. My thoughts to your thoughts. This one memory I share with you.
Tell us. Spock, what are you doing to him?
Thank you. Spock.
Jim, are you okay?
I'm fine, Bones. Fine. But right now, we've got to get Mr. DeSalle back in the driver's seat. Spock, you'll remain here.
Agreed, Captain.
You're not really going to do this.
Well, considering our options, Doctor, we don't have any choice.
Oh, it's insane. We know nothing about this device. I can transmit the specifications from my office, but someone will have to stay to activate it.
I do have some experience in that regard.
All decks, this is the captain speaking. You all know what we're about to do. You're aware of what's at stake. No matter what happens, I want you all to know that there's no other crew I'd rather serve with on any vessel. Kirk out. Status report, Mr. Scott.
Engineering ready as always, Captain.
DeSalle.
Helm standing by.
Brand.
Navigation ready, sir.
Mr. Carr.
Ship system show green, Captain. Structural and aerodynamic force fields at maximum.
Lieutenant Mahura.
All decks report ready, sir. Telemetry uplink established with the Vulcan strike order.
Opinion, Doctor?
I think you're a damn fool. And that guy with the ears is even worse.
I'll take that as a yes, then, Bones. Mr. Sal, red alert. Take a seat.
Aye, sir.
Lieutenant Uhura, open a channel to the surface.
Aye, sir.
Commander Spock, our nose is pointed towards the barn.
I suggest you open the door.
Very well, Captain.
What are you?
A question.
Gateway, I wish to...
Since before your sun burned out in space, and before your race was born, I have awaited a question.
Range to go, 50 kilometers.
Come on, Spock. Gateway, I wish to view the history of the planet Earth.
Now, sir.
Mm-hmm.
positions, everyone.
Lieutenant Uhura,
status report.
All decks report ready, Captain. No injuries or casualties, sir.
Mr. Rand.
All astronavigation landmarks confirmed.
We are 14 years in the past, Captain. The year 2254.
Well done, Mr. DeSalle. Well done.
Sir.
The Enterprise. Hail them, Lieutenant.
Hailing frequencies open.
This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Farragut calling the Enterprise.
This is the USS Enterprise. Captain Christopher Pike commanding. And Steve Garavik is captain of the Farragut. So who the devil are you?
That's going to be somewhat difficult to explain. But it's absolutely vital that you listen to what I have to say. I invite you to beam aboard the Farragut. Bring your senior staff with you if you prefer.
Captain, I verified their ship's registry and command codes. But much of the vessel's internal configuration does not match fleet specifications.
How about this, Captain? You and your senior officers beam over here, and I promise I'll have a security team standing by. Pike out.
Forward phaser, affirmative.
Number one, care to hear this explanation?
Certainly, sir.
Dr. Boyce, meet us in the transporter room. Bring a Klingon to my ship and I'm supposed to trust you? All explanations are off. Take them to the brig.
No, wait. Captain Pike, you're right. At least, sort of. It's well... We're from your future.
Dr. Boyce, can that thing test for insanity?
No.
If that is a weapon...
I was going to offer my scanner. It can detect even the most minor fluctuations in brain chemistry or synaptic malfunction. In other words...
It could test for insanity. Thank you. I'll trust my own instruments for now.
Well, Doctor?
They are as they appear to be. Two humans and one Klingon. Completely normal. As for if they're from the future...
You've got our communicators and medical scanner. You can see that they're much more advanced than your own. So are the weapons on our ship. We could have destroyed you with our torpedoes long before we were in range of your phasers. Have you asked yourselves why we didn't?
I can think of 100 reasons.
Perhaps to commandeer the Enterprise as you did Farragut.
I didn't commandeer the Farragut. You're approaching a source of high temporal disturbance, am I right?
Spock here. Captain, we are approaching the coordinates of the temporal disturbance.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Have Mr. Tyler reduce speed to half impulse.
And when you get there, you'll find a device that's so destructive it will be laying waste to planets for many years to come. Chris, someone told me that you were going to be... difficult to convince. He told me to remind you that you once lost your heart on a world where leaves sing and dreams find life.
Who told you that?
Another Starfleet officer who holds his former captain in high regard. They tell me he's going to be my first officer in the future. At least if we survive to face that future. Commander Spock.
Captain, we're approaching the coordinates of the time ripple. We are not the only one.
Grace Klingon.
No response, Captain.
It's not the same.
No. But maybe this is what they looked like before doing years of battle.
Or perhaps this is a design from an opposing side.
The winning side.
You have something to share?
Captain, that is an unmanned weapon from the future.
That's ridiculous. It would have been impossible for our technology to have advanced so quickly.
It's not our weapon.
But we do have an idea on how to destroy this thing. My science officer will provide you with the necessary specifications. Chris, our two ships are going to have to work together if we're going to destroy this thing.
In 1 minute, then beam back to your ship and transmit the data.
Kirk to Farragut. Get us back quick, Rand, and stand by to raise the deflector shields as soon as we're aboard.
Yes, sir.
Red alert!
Red alert. All hands man your battle stations. This is not a drill.
You know what to do, Mr. Karg.
Aye, sir.
Rand, plot our intercept course. Let's see if we can take some of the heat off the Klingons.
Ship's weapons at full charge, Captain.
I suggest you target these coordinates.
Very good. Mr. Tyler, one quick pass to get its attention.
Aye, sir. I think you've got its attention, Captain.
Recharge weapons. Number one, what's your summary of Kirk's data?
I'd say they're being optimistic, Captain.
That was a disruptor hit!
Captain, the Klingon is firing at the Enterprise.
Hail them.
The Klingon is hailing us, sir.
I'm Captain James T.
Stay out of this fight, Earth, sir. We don't need help from your garbage scow and your weapons of peace and your weakling starship. This prize is ours.
Commander, without our help, there will be no prize. You will die.
With honor? Shun!
Father!
Who dares?
I am Karg, son of Korog Gambrigia. Javit.
Sir, the Enterprise is signaling ready.
I see my son in you. But gratefully changed. What sort of trick is this?
It is no trick, Father. We are joined with the Earthers to stop this killing machine.
Then together we shall. Then afterwards, you'll join me in skinning the Earth, sir. Chabak!
Father!
Captain, it's turning back towards us.
What the hell have they gotten us into?
Deflector modifications complete. Waiting on the signal from Farragut.
I'm getting pretty damn tired of waiting for this Captain Kirk. Let's send that monster back where it came from.
Captain.
I see it, Mr. Karg. As soon as we're into position, fire into that thing.
Captain, engineering reports deflector is over 120%.
It was never made for this kind of work.
The Enterprise wants to live as much as we do, number one. She won't fail us.
It is preparing to fire, Captain.
Keep us out of reach, DeSalle.
That was my plan, sir.
Kyle, take over navigation.
Dr. McCoy to the bridge. Medical emergency.
You call that staying out of reach, mister?
No, sir.
Laura, can you raise the Enterprise?
I'll try, sir. Enterprise, this is Farragut.
Come in, Enterprise. Do you read?
Farragut, calling Enterprise. Please respond.
Acknowledge!
Aye, sir.
This is crazy. Steady, Mr. Tyler.
In order to make this work, we have to stay right in its line of fire? This is suicide!
It's turning towards us again.
Sal.
Trying, Captain.
Status, Mr. Scott.
Circuits overloaded, Captain.
How long do you intend this to go on? As long as it takes.
Captain, the Enterprise cannot survive another attack.
Sir, Enterprise is charging weapons.
Anti-proton readings are spiking. The planet killer is also preparing to fire.
Be destroyed.
Kyle, the Sal.
Primary systems failing.
Pump controls are sluggish, sir.
I'm getting high anti-proton readings.
All hands, brace for impact.
Enterprise, hold your fire.
I'll be damned.
The Farragut distracted it. Made it stop firing at us.
Kirk took the heat off us. Let's see if we can do the same for him. Under and over, Mr. Tyler.
Aye, sir.
Captain, I've been studying the data from their planet killer.
There may be a way to slow it down, but it involves a considerable amount of waste.
All this? For a history we don't know? For people we may or may not become? Captain, call it off while you still can.
Shield energy is fluctuating, Captain.
Sir, the Enterprise. It is gone.
Gone?
They intercepted the beam meant for us, and then...
vaporized.
Casualty reports coming in from all decks, sir. Kyle, sir? Class K planetoid bearing 230.
Are we going to hide, Captain?
Hide? You're damn right, Mr. Card.
Kirk, this is Pike. Oh. Veer off! Veer
Captain,
off!
Captain, it's the...
Do it, Helm. Full thrusters.
Now, Sal.
Kapla!
Let's get the wind out of it right enough.
Kirk, that fancy ship of yours can get off the mat. It's time we finish this thing off.
Aye, aye, Captain. Helm, firing position.
Keep it steady, Mr. Tyler.
Right, sir.
Number one!
Readings off the scale, Captain. It is working.
Lieutenant Uhura, stand down from Red Alert and hail the Enterprise. Coming on screen, sir.
Captain.
Captain.
Well, Kirk, I'm surprised to see that fancy ship of yours still in one piece.
Looks like the Enterprise will be around for a few more years as well. Although may heaven help the engineer that's got to oversee that refit.
Refit? What makes you think she needs a refit?
Thanks for your help. The Guardian should retrieve us soon.
Good luck, Captain Kirk.
The same, Captain Pike. Mr. Card.
I have no explanation, Captain. All indications are that by correcting the timeline, we shall be returned to our own history.
It seems Mr. Card miscalculated. The planet killer moved ahead in time by only a few years.
How few?
Uncertain.
We'll have to go after it.
Request permission to return to duty.
Granted, Lieutenant. Assume your station. Mr. Card, feed your time calculations to the navigation console. Rand, you'll have to follow it.
Sir?
It gives off time ripples. You and DeSalle will have to track it by the flow of time. Currents, eddies, bent blades of grass, whatever it takes.
Yes, sir.
Understood, Captain.
Mr. Karg, prepare your calculations for slingshot effect.
Hold on, Kirk. Our two ships together barely survived last time. The Enterprise will see this through.
Out of the question, Chris. The Enterprise could never survive the pounding of breakaway.
Shall I alert Starfleet, Captain?
No. You've been telling that many people may contaminate the future.
Just keep your eyes open for us. Kirk out. Helm, let's go.
Six hundred days to go. 400. 300. Mr. Rand.
I see.
Just in course.
Farragut, do you read?
We're still in the past.
Farragut, do you read?
Mr. Kark?
Our time coordinates are correct, Captain.
I think I can clear up the signal, sir. On screen, Lieutenant.
Farragut, do you read? Pike calling Farragut.
Pike? Where's Enterprise? How did you know where to find us?
Find you? I wasn't even looking.
Captain, it is possible the currents in time we were following.
Also washed Pike up on the same shore.
And the planet killer is less than 15 minutes behind us.
I was afraid you were going to say that, Mr. Karg. Kirk, I've got a J-class full of green cadets on a training mission.
The J-class vessel may not have enough power.
That's why you're headed for the hangar deck, Mr. Karg. I want you to find out how many shuttlecraft and how much antimatter we can spare. Mr. Scott.
Aye, sir.
Take the mains offline and ramp them up 25 points past the red line. I don't want that thing to have any trouble finding us at the supper table. Now on your way. Fleet Captain. Shall we make sure our guest receives the appropriate welcome?
Your place or mine.
Scatter Bridge. It's time to ring the dinner bell. All right, beastie. Come and get it.
Doomsday machine is coming in range.
Stand by to sound.
Five.
Four. Three. Two.
One. Zero. So, I'm getting massive antiproton readings.
On screen. Shields, full reverse. Get us out of here.
Life support's gone on. Main power failure. Switching to auxiliary.
Auxiliary will not be enough for the deflector charge, Captain. We need more power.
Or more direct power.
Captain, that heading will take us right
into... Right into the belly of that beast.
Kirk, what the blazes are you doing?
Saving the future.
Not alone.
Computer, this is the captain. Destruct sequence, code
captain,
1.
Captain, I'm getting new readings!
From where?
This is Admiral Kirk. Get out of there now!
Do it, Helm. Full thrusters.
Not dead, just knocked out for a while.
Then let's finish it.
The anti-proton charge will only overload when the machine is operating.
He's right. The chance will come soon enough. I suggest you begin your repairs.
I'm getting pretty damn tired of this. Is time travel just something you guys do in the future?
Chris, it's good to see you on your feet.
I'm guessing that you're from the future, Admiral.
That is a logical assumption. 2293, to be precise.
Admiral, I assume your appearance here is no accident.
No.
In our timeline, the destruction of the Farragut was insufficient to stop the planet killer.
We've pulled every ship out of mothballs to fight those things.
Science of the 24th century is sufficiently advanced to destroy a doomsday machine.
Without sacrificing a starship or a crew. And if we can stop this one, this war will never occur.
But we have to get it from our time to yours.
It's as simple as that.
Captain Pike, I am reading high levels of delta radiation aboard your vessel.
The baffle plating around our reactor took the worst beating. We're making repairs. Pike out.
Admiral. He knows something. I see your readings from the Guardian.
Captain? There it is.
Farragut to Kirk. Admiral, I know what you and Spock are trying to do. You can't do this. Things have to follow their natural course.
It's not the natural course if it's because that thing attacked. Isn't that what we're trying to do here? Making right what the Doomsday Machine put wrong?
But this isn't wrong. Chris Pike's accident is part of your history. It should be part of mine.
Not this time.
Admiral, there's gotta be another way.
Captain, believe me when I say, this is the better way.
The Enterprise transporters have been activated. Someone just beamed aboard the Dacus.
Admiral. Kirk!
He stopped transmitting, sir.
Open that door and you will flood the ship with Delta radiation.
Not if we seal this room and recirculate the air.
Captain.
Chris.
You cannot.
Maybe you're right.
We'll die if we don't get them out.
Chris!
Ambassador, you're needed back aboard the Enterprise.
Captain, Enterprise has reactivated her transporters.
Status report, Mr. Scotty.
Everything's ready, Captain.
Well done,
Scotty.
Carr, contact both ships.
Yes, sir.
We've played tag with Doomsday long enough. It's time we finish this.
Readings off the scale.
Anti-proton energy was at sufficient levels, Captain. It has gone back where it came from.
Well done, Admiral. Well done.
Fleet Captain Pike has suffered severe radiation poisoning. The Daedalus will make it to Starbase 11, where he will receive the best medical attention.
I only wish we could have done more.
We will, Captain. We will.
It's only a matter of time. Oh, and Jim, contact Carol. It's a boy.
Do not despair. There are alternatives. The Spock you know will soon arrive. His plan will work, Captain. It is a foregone certainty. But I must know it is what you want. Captain, do you remember what Dr. Boyce often said about living one's life to the fullest? One lives life as it happens, meeting it head on, or turning his back on it and withering away. Do not choose to wither away. Live long and prosper. Energize.
Captain Pike. Captain Pike? You remember these gentlemen. They wanted to visit you.
Thank you.
Baggins, greatest little hobbit of them all.
Okay.
Yes.